So if you Google Computer Science Otago, you'll find this video of me talking about my computer science degree. But fun fact, I actually started off my university degree with a completely different major. This is a story of how I ventured into the world of tech and what I've learned along the way. So growing up, I always thought that I would go down the healthcare career path. I worked hard, got the grades, and enrolled into the health sciences first year program at the University of Otago. And this is basically like pre-med. These are the papers that I did that year. Biology, chemistry, biochemistry, physics, human anatomy, public health, and Maori. This year was pivotal for me in so many aspects, and I realized that I didn't actually want to go down this healthcare path anymore. So once the year ended, I started researching different career options that I could take from here. I looked into a whole bunch of areas, and eventually I settled on computer science for three main reasons. The first being that technology is what shapes the future, so I thought that studying computer science would give me a good head start into the tech industry. The second reason is that tech skills like coding especially are in high demand, and I knew that there would be good career prospects once I graduated. For example, I could become a software engineer, could become a product manager, UX UI designer, technical consultant, stuff like that. Or alternatively, you could also just create your own startup or even just be a coding instructor, you know, like there are so many options that you can do with this degree. And the last reason is I just liked how computer science was a lot more about problem solving than just memorizing bits of information and regurgitating them. I just found it so cool how you can use code to create anything, just like how this tech YouTuber, Ray's son, created this program to help analyze his dancing skills. Like, how cool is that? And I should also mention that I was watching a lot of female tech YouTubers like HelloMayuko, and they really inspired me, and that's also kind of why I decided to start my own tech YouTube channel. So thanks for following my journey. I decided to add on entrepreneurship as well because I thought business skills would always be helpful regardless of what you end up doing, and I thought it would be a nice complement to computer science. So after my summer break, I was ready to start my new degree in computer science and entrepreneurship. The good thing about doing computer science is that because health science is first year and computer science are both bachelors of science, it meant that all my points from health science's first year could carry over to my new degree, meaning that instead of having to take 8 or 7 papers for all my following years, I could just take 6, which freed up a lot of my time and enabled me to just fully immerse myself into the whole university culture, joining clubs and activities and stuff like that. So yeah, it all worked out in the end. These are the papers that I did that year. The ones that I've marked in asterisks are the computer science papers. Comp 160, Comp 150, Comp 101, and BSNS 112. Comp 150 was my introduction to programming. We learned Python and fundamental CS concepts like variables, arrays, loops, and algorithms. I really loved this paper on Python because of how intuitive everything was. And I'm really glad that Python was my first ever programming language as well, actually, because it was so beginner friendly yet powerful at the same time. In Comp 160, we delved into Java, which I found to be just a little bit clunkier than Python. We also learned fundamental CS concepts like classes, objects, inheritance, polymorphism, encapsulation, basically a whole bunch of concepts. But what I liked the most about this paper was the GUI section, because we got to make all these graphical user interfaces with shapes, and I just loved the whole visual aspect of it. In Comp 101, we learned a whole bunch of stuff. We learned about binary systems, we learned about Shannon's entropy, entity relationship diagrams, databases, SQL, we also got to program in R. It was basically everything, everywhere, all at once. But I'm really grateful for this paper though, because it introduced us to a wide variety of topics, and it set us up well for the following years. Now, for BSNS 112, this was actually a business paper, but it was still considered as part of my core CS papers because of how maths heavy it was, statistics to be specific. So yeah, I pretty much just learned about statistics, and we also got to learn how to use SPSS, which was pretty cool. It was a nice contrast to my other programming papers that I was doing at the time. So as you can see, this was a very significant year for me. It was my first year transitioning into tech and business from a health sciences background, and literally none of my friends or family members were on this path. I never thought I would be on this path either because I just never stumbled upon it. But I like this quote by Shunryu Suzuki. It goes, "In the beginner's mind, there are many possibilities. In the expert's mind, there are few. I wrote my first line of code, I joined my first hackathon, I won my first startup competition, and even got to go to Canada for it." By the end of the first year, I gotten so much hands-on experience that I wouldn't have otherwise gotten in the classroom and met so many amazing people. These opportunities that I'd seized led me to even greater opportunities. It was basically like a ripple effect. So if you're starting something new, my advice to you would be to go full forth and embrace it. See it as a new adventure with all its ups and downs, and make the most of opportunities that come your way. In my second year of my degree, these were all the papers that I did. Basically, more CS fundamentals like algorithms and data structures, but we also covered computer architecture, operating systems, and networking. COSC 241 was pretty much Java again, and the continuation of Comp 160. We delved deep into a whole bunch of concepts like algorithm complexity, recursion, sorting algorithms, and also data structures like stacks, queues, heaps, and linked lists. Now, COSC 243, man, where do I even start with this? Learning about computer architecture and operating systems was so complex, it made me wonder how on earth we humans even figured out how to build a computer. Who even thought of all these processes and how everything would fit together? Just blew my mind. Anyway, there were a lot of interesting concepts like memory and storage allocation, scheduling, data races, and deadlocks. We even got to try assembly language, which was not fun, by the way, and also build our own circuits with breadboards, which was very fun. Just look at how aesthetic and colorful everything is. Now, if I thought computer architecture was complex, man, I was in for a ride for COSC 243. This was an extremely infamous paper and had a notoriously high fail rate. We did a whole bunch of things, which I'm just gonna read out right now. We did big O, big theta, proof techniques, induction, data structures like hash tables, binary search trees, red-black trees, B-trees, graphs like breadth-first and depth-first search, Dijkstra's algorithm, greedy algorithms, and that's not even everything, bro. We also learned about C programming, which is low-level programming, which made me really appreciate what we have with Java and Python. I studied so much for this paper, and looking back at my notes, it made me realize how beautiful computer science actually is. Yes, it's complex, but once you learn the logic and go through the steps, you learn that it all makes sense, and it's actually all about patterns. Now, speaking of patterns, there was a lot of this in COSC 244, especially in the signals and encoding section. Alongside that, we also did medium access control, logical link control, TCP/IP stuff, LAN, WAN, wireless networking, etc. So as you can probably tell, second year was a huge step up from first year. The lectures would go so in-depth in the concepts, and I was struggling to make sense of it all. But here's what I learned. Start with past year papers, even if you feel like you haven't grasped the concepts yet. Work through it and identify which areas you're unsure about, and then seek help from your lecturer, friends, study material, or even the internet. No, actually, especially the internet. Oftentimes, you'll find that past year papers only cover certain topics, not all, and you just have to nail those concepts. And the more past year papers you do, the more you can identify a trend in the patterns, and you can kind of strategize around that. So it's all about studying smart, not studying hard. Anyway, the summer of my second year, I ended up doing this internship at a local tech startup called Cloud Cannon, and I made a video of it actually, so you can watch it up here. Before I knew it was the last year of my degree. Aside from the usual programming and CS fundamental papers, we also did interesting ones like AI and cloud computing. COSC 326 was a purely practical paper with 13 challenges that we had to solve. It was a combination of individual, peer, and group challenges. It's quite interesting actually because the focus of this paper was how you solve problems. Some of the challenges didn't even require you to code, you just had to think it through, explain your reasoning, and present it. Because remember, coding is just a tool to solve problems. At the end of the day, you still need to think through how you want to solve the problem first before you can even use the tool. Some example questions were writing a program to figure out the length of a string and figuring out how an elevator decides which floor to reach next, because it's actually not as simple as you think. COSC 343 was all about artificial intelligence. Yes, our favorite buzzword. This paper broke it down to what it is at its core. Neural networks, reinforcement learning, adversarial search, genetic algorithm, Bayesian reasoning. These were just some of the concepts, to name a few. The assignments in this paper, while being a nightmare, were still pretty cool, I must concede. One of them was to write a program which would make a robot traverse a certain pattern of tiles to reach its target, which was the milk carton here. And the other one was to use genetic algorithm to simulate natural selection in a game. COSC 344 was about database theory and applications. Now remember Comp 101 that I did back in first year? Well, thank God for that paper, because who knew that 2 years later, I'd be learning about databases and SQL again. Finally, my last paper was COSC 349, Cloud Computing. We learned about what cloud computing actually is, stuff like software as a service, platform as a service, infrastructure as a service, Kubernetes, orchestration, cloud law, etc. But my most memorable experience from this paper, and quite possibly my whole computer science degree actually, was making this flat bills manager with my friend as part of an assignment. It would keep track of all the different types of bills, how much each member had to pay, and when they paid their bills. This project was such a great learning experience for the both of us because we pretty much learned how to use stuff like React, Tailwind CSS, and Express, etc. for the first time via this project. So it was like project-based learning. As I was responsible for the design and the front-end code, I realized that I really enjoyed the visual side of programming, and I guess that's how I got into front-end software engineering in the end. Now looking back on my 4 years of university, I'm so grateful for all the experiences and memories that I had. I grew a lot as a person, and I met so many interesting people from all walks of life. You see, university is so much more than just getting a degree. Yes, sure, you learn stuff at university to get that degree, but once you actually enter the real world and start working, you'll realize that this learning never ends. You'll have to continuously learn on the job and also in your own time. So if you're still at university or you're going to university soon, my advice to you would be to make the most of the whole experience. Go and meet new people, join clubs and activities, and try new things. Discover yourself. It's a period of discovery and growth. So yeah, that's my whole CS degree in a nutshell. As someone who started studying computer science with no programming background, I just wanted to say that if I can do it, you can too. Don't be intimidated by computer science. Yes, it's hard, but nothing is too hard if you put your mind to it and see it as a journey instead of just focusing on the destination. And if you're a girl, do not let anybody tell you that girls can't code. Girls can definitely code, and we need more women in tech to shape the future. Being a woman in tech can be isolating, so it's really important to have a community around you. So go and join a Women in Tech club, and if there isn't one, then start your own. Now, if there's only one thing you take away from this video, let it be this. Life doesn't always go as expected, and that's alright. Oftentimes, it's the most unexpected things that happen to us that are the most pivotal in shaping our life. I always thought I'd be a healthcare professional, but I ended up in tech, and it opened my eyes to a whole new world of possibilities. If you want to learn more about computer science, you can check out this tech playlist over here. There's pros and cons for every path you take, opportunity costs for everything, and I'm definitely not advocating for tech over healthcare, because at the end of the day, it's really all about what you think would be the best for you. So yeah, whatever stage in life you are in right now, I wish you all the best. You can do it. Stay strong, stay well, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!